Greetings. This is the Elder Black Light. Welcome to the God Zone. Now, there's a sister, she got a YouTube channel called Redirector, and on YouTube I seen this video about, she had a video about this brother that you're looking at. I think his name is Moses, I'm not for sure, but we're going to get into it. Created he could snatch water out the atmosphere and make tons and tons of clean drinking water. And her video read like, this black man creates water machine, but he's gonna need protection. And so I went to her channel, but I got some more videos besides the one she put up on this brother. And he said he got the patent on the machine, and he gave some demonstrations. But I went to another video. And it says that the Israelis created a machine. Before we get to that, I'm reading from the Supreme Wisdom book. Now, you know Master Farad came back in 1930, right? This proves, what I'm about to read, proves that Master Farad is God. There's a question and answer part. It's called First Examination Assignment of Mr. Elijah Muhammad. And question 8 says it like this. It says the earth is approximately covered under water. Now this is back in 1930. Between 1930 and 1933. And he says, now he set up the Lost Found Nation of Islam in Detroit, Michigan. They call that Temple Number One. And Elijah Muhammad was a student on his way to become his messenger. And he gave him an examination. Says the earth, he says, what makes rain, hail, snow, and earthquakes? What makes rain, hail, snow, and earthquakes? Answer. The earth is approximately covered under water, approximately 3/4 of its surface. The sun and moon having attracting power on our planet, while our planet making the terrific speed of 1,037 1/3 miles on its way around the sun. The sun draws the water up into the earth's rotation, which is called gravitation. In its fine mist that the naked eye can hardly detect, but as this mist ascends higher and increasing with other mists of water in different currents of the atmosphere until when she becomes heavier than gravitation. Then she distills back to the earth in the form of drops of water or drops of ice, which depends on how heavy the mist was in the current of the air it was in. There are some layers of currents of air real cold and warm, and some very swift and changeable. So when the water strikes one of these cold currents, it becomes solid ice in small round drops and forms, or in a light fluffy form, which is called snow. But this water is not ever drawn above 6 miles from the Earth's surface by the sun and moon. The reason it rains back on our planet is because it cannot get out of the Earth's sphere with its high speed of rotation around the sun. Makes it impossible. Now, this is what Master Farad Muhammad came to us with on the east side of Detroit, Black Bottom, in the 30s, in the 1930s. Now this brother here, he made a water machine. Now you know, I told brothers, I said that we got the Detroit, Michigan, got the largest body of fresh water in the whole planet, and water is becoming a problem. And brothers, you know, their minds is asleep, wrapped up in foolishness. And Detroit was a majority black city at one time. I don't know about now, but it was over 80-some percent, 87, something like that. But they moved out, went to Texas. Now he's in Texas. He used to be a Texas Ranger. He's in Texas, where they running out of water. So he said he gonna come up to Flint with his machine. But I want you to check out something before we get too deep into what I'm about to say.
Water.
A problem the retired ranger spent the past 4 years working to eliminate.
All the water that we need it exists right here in the air.
He believed so strongly in that idea. In 2015, West invented an atmospheric water generator, or AWG, a machine that takes in air and turns it into drinking water.
We're at the place now, I think, making 50, 100, 200, 250,000, a million gallons of water at an incredibly low energy consumption. I think cheaper than groundwater by far. Cheaper than desalination.
So far, 12 of these AWGs exist. West planted them in 3 areas, including the Bahamas, Puerto Rico, and Flint, Michigan.
I need to engage with the people here, and I need to show them what this machine does, and they need to understand that it is their machine, and I am here for them.
West, 2 billion people around the world lack access to clean drinking water, but this Israeli machine could change that. It literally makes clean water out of thin air. Bottoms up. This is the scary part. In 2025, it's estimated that 2/3 of the world won't have access to clean drinking water. That's just 6 years from now. 6 years!
The Israeli company WaterGen says they have the solution. Their technology captures humidity in order to make drinking water out of air. Then it cleans and adds the minerals necessary to make the water safe to drink.
This machine can serve around 2,500 people. This machine is making around 900 liters of pure drinking water. We have here the pipe that is going down to the offices and providing to the offices the drinking water. We install the dispensers in the offices, in the meeting rooms, and you can drink it in the building.
And welcome back to Redirecting. I have a different story that I'm going to be sharing today. This one was so amazing and incredible to me that I felt that I had to bring this story out on this channel. And I hope that many others will see this, because what this guy is doing is incredible. As a matter of fact, I believe that because of what he is doing and what he has invented, he's going to need some protection. I'm going to go ahead and roll the video clip, and then I'll be right back, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about.
Clean drinking water, a natural resource we often take for granted near the Great Lakes. But Moses West knows...
Now, I don't know if the Israelis... If he sold everything to the Israelis or whatever he did, but they're taking claim for it. And I didn't hear them mention his name in their video. So I think, you know, as soon as we get inventions, we take it to the Caucasian and we don't get the credit or the paper that is due to us. Maybe just sold it to them for a lump sum of money. But he gonna take it to Flint, and that's a good thing. But what I really wanted you to see was the science that Master Farad Muhammad brought to us almost 100 years ago. This is Black Light, and we're going to get a little deeper in the science, because we need scientists, some young scientists. So y'all brothers, get off them video machines, get off to the sports, to see the black man is God. He got 7 ounces of brain, while the Caucasian only has six. I think we got 7.5. Anyway, this is Black Light. Stay tuned.